Hello everybody, welcome to a new tutorial. This tutorial we will learn how to create login and registration system using Firebase email and password authentication and real-time database. As shown in example here, when user click on register button, it directs him to registration activity and type his name and the email address and click register. If registration is successfully, it directs him to login activity and he can now log into his account. When user has successfully logged in his account, he can change the password by adding old password and adding new password, and he can now change the password. And he can log in again successfully, and also he can change his profile image. And this tutorial learns you how to reduce image size to save the spaces on real-time storage. Okay, the image has uploaded successfully. He can upload another image. All images will be added to his account. And he can use old images also as his profile image. Okay, the user can log out and can send forget email address, forget password. Now an email sent to reset password. When he go to his email address and he will receive reset password for the login registration project and click the link. Now he can change the password again. Okay, now password has changed successfully. And when he returned to login activity and tried the new password, now login is successful by the new password. Please don't forget to like and subscribe, and let's start a new Android study project. I have started the new Android study project with name Firebase login and registration. First of thing, we need to set up the Gradle file. This is the required dependencies. For first design the project, we need to design dependency and material edit text and circle image view, glide and recycler view. For Gradle project Gradle level, no changes required. Sync now. Okay, synchronization successfully done. Second step is Android manifest file. We need to add permission to use internet. Second step is setting the color and style. The primary dark color is orange color and color primary is white. And also color accent is white. For styles, we need to add style. I have added new style with name menu style and background theme app combat light and background color white. Next step, we need to create two drawable files for border. We need to create white border and we need to also need to create orange border. Go to drawable and create new drawable resource file and name it white border. Okay, we need to delete selector and add layer list. Inside layer list, we need to add item. Inside item, we need to add shape. With property shape rectangle. Inside shape, we need to add two properties. We need to add solid. With color primary is white and we need to add corners with radius 15 dB. Okay, our shape is ready. You can copy this white border XML file and paste it again in drawable and name it orange border. Next step, we need to set up our activities. We need to start with main activity and go to XML file for main activity. Delete the text view and change constraint layout to relative layout. And add background color primary dark. Inside relative layout, create linear layout, match parent and drop content for height and orientation vertical, and layout center vertical is true because we need to the linear layout to adjust it in the center of screen. Inside linear layout, add text view and name it login and change the color to primary and the size 50 dB, bold and margin top is 10 dB. Under text view, we need to create frame layout. Frame layout will take the background as white border and elevation 10 dB, and outline ambient shadow color is color gray. Inside it, we need to add material edit text. The material edit text with layout height match parent because the parent height is 60 dB and margin of parent frame layout is 20 dB. So the material edit text has mid floating label normal and hand email address because it for email and with padding 16 dB and mid base color primary dark and background tint primary dark and text color hint primary dark. This is the attributes required. We need to copy this frame layout. Change it to password. and for hint password. Okay, under password material edit text, we need to add progress bar and make it visibility gone. Next, we need to add login button. The login button required to be in frame parent layout. The parent layout with background white border, and the background of the button is selectable item background to make the button is selectable or clickable. We need to copy this button and paste it here and change it to register and change ID to register with the same attributes. Next step, we need to add text view for forget password. The forget password text view with attribute text color primary and links clickable true. Next step, we need to create register activity. Register activity XML file requires bar layout file. It looks like that. So we need to create new layout file. Name it bar layout. We need to add toolbar. The toolbar with attributes orientation vertical. Okay, maybe not required. And match parent for layout width and wrap content for layout height and background color primary dark to get color orange and text title color as color primary to get color of text or title as white and style. Base theme overlay, app combat activity, app combat dark action bar, and the pop-up theme as menu style with ID toolbar. We need to include this toolbar, but first we need to change the constraint layout to relative layout, and we need to include ID. At ID toolbar and layout. At layout bar layout. Next, we need to create linear layout under bar layout and with attribute layout below at ID toolbar to make it under the toolbar. Inside linear layout, we need to add the registration data. We need to add widgets for registration data. We need to add text view to show the activity type and material text, edit text. We need to copy it from main activity XML file. So we need to get this frame layout and copy it. Change the hint to username and ID to username. And next one for email and one for password. And with hand password. And one for mobile, and name it ID mobile. With input type text, text phonetic, and the input type for password, text password, and we need to change input type for username to text person name. After that, we need to add radio button group. The radio button group with background orange border and orientation vertical and layout head wrap content and with ID radio button. Inside radio button group, we need to add two radio buttons for gender. The first one for male and with text color, color primary and bottom tint color primary. Copy this radio button and paste it and name it female and with text female. Next step, we need to add progress bar. The progress bar with color primary dark and visibility, make it gone. Next, we need to add registration button. We need to copy it from main activity. Go to register button and copy this frame layout with button. So we need to change the color of frame layout to orange border. And change the text color to color primary. And with the background to selectable item background. Okay, our registration activity is ready now. Next step, we need to add our project to Firebase. This step we will start with tools and open Firebase Assistant. If Firebase Assistant doesn't installed in your Android Studio, open file and settings and go to plugins. Inside plugins, search for Firebase. Okay, it's Firebase service already installed. After installing it and Android Studio will restart, open tools and select Firebase Assistant. First of all, we need to add authentication to the project. Email and password authentication. First step, connect to Firebase. This step will direct you to the browser and opens Firebase. Log into Firebase with your developer account, and once you add your project and click continue. Not required Google Analytics and click create project. Okay, now click continue. And click connect to Firebase to Android app. Okay, the project is connected successfully. Okay, and the project here connected. Okay, second step is adding Firebase authentication to your app and click on this spot. This automatically adds the required dependencies and reset the project and click accept changes. It already adds the Firebase dependencies authentication. Okay, done successfully. Now we need to go to Firebase and go to console. We note that the project created here. Click the project name. Go to authentication. Click on it. And click set sign up method. And go to email and password and edit it. Enable the two buttons and click save. Now go to database. And go to the section of Realtime database and click create database and start in test mode. Okay, now we have warning here. Your security rules are defined as public, so anyone can still modify or delete data in your database. Go to rules. Now we need to change these rules. First thing, we need to add rules for users table. Under users reference or table, we need to add variable user ID, and here we need to add read and write rules. Here we need to add another condition, and user ID and authentication not equal to null. Okay, so the user cannot read to the database if he is not authenticated and the user ID is identified or is the same as authentication.user or unified ID. Now we need to publish, but before it we need to add another rules for read. And add for read. And click publish. And return to database. We note that the warning has removed. Okay. Next step, go to storage and we need to get started with storage. Click next and select the server location. Okay, we need to create new folder and name it profile images and click add folder. In this folder we will add the profile images. Okay, now go to your Android studio . After that we need to return to assistant and we need to add real-time database to enable it. Save and retrieve data and add real-time database to your app. Accept changes. And return to assistant and go to storage and upload and download to cloud and add cloud storage to your app. So for now our project is ready for Firebase login and registration. Now go to register activity and start to find material edits and the buttons in register activity and the progress bar. First we need to set the toolbar in the register activity. Now we define new toolbar and it's find view by ID and set support action bar by toolbar and its title and toolbar.zNavigation on click listener to return to the main activity. Next step, we need to find these widgets by ID. Then we need to add click listener to register button. Okay. When user click on register button, we need to define the strings of username, email, password, mobile, and we need to get the selected gender and check the selected gender is not null, and if it's null, we need to create toast to remind the user to select gender. Then here we need to add the final string gender for selected gender to get the text and check the all edit text not empty. If it not empty, then we need to call the register method inside register activity. The registration process requires to create an instance of Firebase authentication and name it Firebase authentication and create new instance for this authentication is equal to Firebase authentication dot get instance and we need to initialize progress bar and then to create new user by Firebase authentication and select option was create user with email and password and first parameter is email text and second parameter is password text and add onComplete listener new onComplete listener. If task is successful, here we need to save the user data to the Firebase database. We will do that by defining the Firebase user. We need to create an instance of Firebase user. Registered user is equal to Firebase authentication to get current user. We need to get user ID string. Is equal to Firebase user to get user ID. Then we need to create database reference instance. And we need to define database reference is equal to Firebase database dot get instance dot get reference. The reference name here should be the same as reference name is in database. We need to copy it from database and copy the reference name here, users, and paste it here. Dot child, this child is the created user ID string. When we need to save the user data, the username, email, text, mobile, gender, we need to create map, hash map of type string hash map is equal to new hash map, and put the user data to hash map. Here we need to make sure the names, because the key value of hash map will be the child name of the reference. It cannot be changed after that. Make sure the name, say we need to make user ID. We need to copy this line and paste it here. One for username and with value username, and one for email and value email, and one for gender and its value gender, and one for mobile and its value for mobile. Another we need to another hash map for profile image or image URL, and with default value default. And add this hash map to database reference by using database reference dot set value, and we need to cast hash map dot add on complete listener, new on complete listener, if task is successful we need to start the login activity. Also we need here to stop progress bar. And we need to add required KitKat. And we need to assert user ID not equal null. And if the task of creating email and username is not successful, else you will need to stop progress bar. And create toast. We need to get task exception. And it requires v not null. Okay, our registration activity is ready to register new user. Now we need to set up our login activity, open main activity. and open an activity XML file. Okay. Now it's everything is ready to code. Now we need to find our widgets for email and password, progress bar and text view for hierarchy password. And we need to find the registration button and login button and redefine the email password and the progress bar. Okay, now we need to set click listener for register button. To start register activity and set on click listener for login button in the on click listener of login button we need to define strings of email text and the password text and if the email and the password is empty we need to toast all fields is required else we need to create login method inside login method we need to create Firebase authentication and initialize it inside main activity Okay, inside login method we need first to initialize progress bar and then we need to get authentication with sign in with email and password here we need to cast text for email and text for password dot add on complete server new on complete listener and if task successful and else we need to toast error and if task is successful we need to go to start activity by initializing new intent else we need to toast task exception so we need to create method create activity for start activity After login, we need to stop progress bar. Go to start activity XML file and change constraint layout to linear layout. With orientation vertical, we need to add profile bar layout so we need to copy this bar layout here and paste it in layout but make sure that in layout file sorry we need to change the name we need to change it to profile bar layout okay Inside profile bar layout, we need to make changes. We need to add relative layout. Inside relative layout, we need to add circle image view. And we need to add text view for username. Now go to start activity XML file and include the profile bar layout. Then add card view match parent for layout height and width, and corner radius by 50 dB and margin bottom by minus 50 dB. To show the corner here, we need to change the background for the activity to color primary dark. It is the layout here. Now go to start the activity Java file. We need to create text view for username and circle image view, and then we need to set toolbar for app start activity. Then we need to find username and circle image view. And private Firebase authentication and private database reference. And we need to instantiate the Firebase authentication. And initialize the Firebase user. And initialize database reference is equal to Firebase database dot get instance dot get reference. The reference name is users dot child is Firebase user dot get unified ID. Then we need to get snapshot for database reference. To add value event listener, sorry. To add value event listener, new value event listener. The value event listener returns data snapshot. Data snapshot requires model file to get it. We need to create new model file, Java file, and name it user data. And inside it, we need to create private string user, sorry, user ID. And we need to make sure it's the same as the database from the register activity over register activity, and copy paste this name. And we need to create two constructors. The first for all variables, and the second is empty constructor. And we need to generate getter and setters for all database. Okay. Now here we need to add the value for users data is equal to data snapshot dot get value users data dot class. So we here can set the username text view by user data username of the user data as following. We here have set text of user data to get username, and we can set the image if it is default. We need to set it as IC launcher background, else we need to use light to load the image to circle image view. Here in database error we need to add toast and to cast the database error dot get message. Okay. Now we need to try our app. Okay, we need here to remove the action bar here. We need to open styles. We need to change it to no action bar and try it again. Let's try it. Okay, I have error here. We need to open lock app. And we need to get the error. And we have error here in register activity, and we need to include layout, but I have added Android layout here. Let's try that again. Okay, register activity is ready. Let's try to add new user. Okay, we need to set the text color. As color primary dark. Sorry, here we need to add username, not email. And we need to click register. Okay. We need to add. Okay, the it works and the name of username appears, and we need to look at Firebase database. We will note that users reference edit and unified ID and the user data. Added here. The next step is image upload. Now we need to enable the user to click the circle image view and to choose his profile image and upload it to real-time storage and database. Let's start. When the user click on the circle image view, the layout appears here with recycler view with grid layout manager and button to open the images from device. We achieve that in start activity by adding click listener to circle image view. Now we need to create two layout files. The first file for select image that contains recycler view and the button. And linear layout with orientation vertical. We need to add recycler view, match parent and wrap content, and ID recycler view. And we need to copy the register button and change the name to open images and each ID open images and change layout height to wrap content and we need to change margin button to 20 dB . The second layout is for single image row. The row layout is relative layout. Contains card view and the relative layout has width 100 dB and height 100 dB and margin 5 dB and the card view has color primary dark and the layout margin of circle image view 3 dB and with profile image ID. Now we need to set on click listener. We need to show it in alert dialog builder. We need to change it to start activity to this. Okay, now I try to close Android Studio and open it again. Okay. Okay, now we need to set layout manager for recycler view as grid layout manager with span count 3 and set has fixed size true. Now we need to create recycler view adapter for selected images. This is a view holder class for recycler view adapter. And we need to cast it to recycler view adapter. And generate methods. Here we need to create model file for list of image URLs. And return to recycler view adapter and create list private list of image list, and we need to create context and generate constructor. And set view holder and in unbind view holder method we need to set the image view using glid and set the image view for each images, and we need to add listener. This listener of circle image view will set the images or previously added images for the user. If the user wants to use settings that provide images of previously added images, he need just to click to the image and it will update the user image profile to the new selected image. Make it final and don't forget to set the item count to the image list size. Then return to the start activity and we need to initialize the recycler adapter. Now we need to create new image list Sorry, I have created image list, but I need list of image list. Also, we need to initialize this image list in onCreate activity. Next step, we need to create collect images method. Collect the images, all the images method takes database reference of profile images. And on add on welcome event listener, we need to clear the image list and loop through the data snapshot to get the each image list URL and add to image list array. On data snapshot error, we need to toast the error. Next, we need to show the alert dialog. We need to define the open image button with the select image layout. And when user clicks the button, the method of open image will called. And we need to create it and start activity. Then we need to show the alert dialog. The open images method, it calls the activity of the images. And here we need to create private static variable for image request. And we need to create an activity result method. In the on activity result method, we need to check the image request and code request is result okay and data not null and data.get data not null. Here we need to also check the storage task is completed or not completed. We need to define new storage task. And check it if it is not null. So we can upload the image. And also we need to create the image URI that come from data, so we need to define private URI image URI. And we need to define it. Is equal to data dot get data. Now we need to create upload image method, and this step is important. First step, create progress dialog. Then we need to check if the image URI is not equal null. In this case, we need to initialize new bitmap. And we need to find the media. Okay, here we need to add try catch. Next step, we need to create byte output array. Next step is to compress image. Sorry, we need to add it inside the if statement. We need to assert bitmap not equal null. Next, we need to create byte array of image. Next step to create storage reference. So we need to define storage reference here. And initialize it in the activity. And the name of the reference, we need to copy it from the storage database. Here we need to set the image URI name by the user name and current time of the system per milli, because we need to the each image the users upload it with unique URI. So we need to make the users data to general variable. Okay. And we need to create storage task. And we need to create storage task to with continuation task. Continuous task. This error will appear. Click Alt Enter and replace Lambda with anonymous class. Here we need to add uncomplete slur. And we need to change the type out or to cast type of task to URI. And cast it as URI. Dot add on failure listener. So this method when the storage task is completed, we need to save the image URI to real-time database to set the current image profile. Here, if task is successful, we need to define the URI for the saved images that come from the task, and we need to convert the download URI to string and create hash map, because we need to update the reference of the user. That image URI, we need to set it to the created URI. So the database reference, after update, we need to create new reference for profile images. So we need to create more images for the single user. So we need to create new reference with child with Firebase user with unified ID. And here we need to create push method, not update method. It push method because every time the user select new image, the new reference or new child will be added to the profile reference. And on failure listener, we need to dismiss progress bar and toast the error. So let's try our project. Okay, let's log in. Okay, let's try to click on the circle image view. Okay, we have toast for permission denied because we need to set permission of real-time database for user info. Open real-time database. Open rules. And copy this user's rules and paste it here, and it changes the user rules to the new reference. Sorry, that is not the reference. Yes, it is. Okay. Here, no toast for permission like appears again. When user clicks on open images, so we need to downloads. Okay, it works successfully, but there is some error here that make the circle image view doesn't appear. We need to show it. Okay, to solve the error, go to register activity and change it to view URL small and user data, change it to URL small. And start activity, change it to URL small. And in recycler adapter, change it to URL small, go to real-time database and delete the profile images. Try run the app. Then go to Firebase again and change the value of image URL to default. And go to storage and delete old images. And open emulator and click on open images. Okay, we need to select another image. Okay, it works perfect. Okay, next step, we need to set forget password. We need to create new activity and name it forget password activity. Now go to XML file for forget password activity and change constant layout to relative layout and include bar layout and add linear layout and create text view and limit reset password and open layout resource file, open register XML file and copy the edit text of email address, copy the frame layout and paste it here. Also we need to copy the register bot and we need to change it its name and change the text of register to send message or send reset message. Okay, sorry, I copied it wrong. And change ID to send message. And add progress bar above the bottom. And make it visibility gone. Finally, we need to add text view below the button and change its color to primary dark and change margin to 20 dB. Now our XML file is ready now. In forgive password activity, three variables for Firebase authentication and progress bar and text view reset state. And create code for toolbar and change the title to reset password and toolbar navigation on click listener used to jump to main activity. Next, we need to define the material edit text and bottom and progress bar and instantiate Firebase authentication instance. And we need to add on click listener for reset password bottom. This process takes 2 steps. First, we need to make progress bar visible, and next we need to fetch sign in method for this email, because we need to check is the email is already registered or not. And if task.getResult.getSignInMethod is empty, we need to stop progress bar, and we need to set the reset state text view to this message. This is not a registered email. You can create new account. Else, that means that the email address already registered, and here we can send password reset password email. And on task complete, if task is successful, we need to make progress bar visibility gone, and we need to set the text view text to this text. Else, we need to set the text of text view by the exception. Okay, let's try it. Okay, let's try the forget password activity. We need to click on forget password text. Okay, I forgot to add on click listener in main activity. We need to define forget password. Let's try it again. Now we need to set the forget password. Now we need to add the email address. And we need to send message. Okay. Now we need to open browser and open the mail. The mail has been received for setting password. And when user click on the link, he can reset password. Okay. And now we need to try to use the old password to log in, and wrong password, we need to change it to the new password. Okay, it's our start activity. Now we need to make changes for main activity XML file and the edit text password. We need to change the text input type to password. The last part is to set the option menu items for change password and logout. We will do that by creating menu layout file. Click on resource folder and right click and create new Android resource directory and set value to menu and click OK. And on menu folder, create new resource menu resource file and name it profile menu. Click OK. Now we need to add items in the menu. I have added two items, the first item for change password and second item for logout. Then we need to create new activity for change password activity. And click finish. Okay, now we need to copy the register activity password. Sorry, I need to open XML file and we need to copy this edit text and open change password activity layout file. Change it to relative layout. Inside relative layout, we need to include the bar layout. And then we need to copy the linear layout. And copy the password edit text. So we need to create three copies. The first one for old password. The second one for new password. The third one to confirm password. Finally, we need to add button to reset or change password. Okay. Now in start activity, we need to override two methods. The first method is on option menu, in create option menu. So in this method, we need to create it in activity itself. And boolean method and option item selected. Inside on create option menu, we need to remove this line and fill it menu layout. And custom menu, and then return true. And option menu item, we need to get ID of item. And check if ID is equal to R dot ID dot, we need to return to menu layout file to copy the ID of this menu item, else if ID is equal to R dot ID dot logout ID and return true. In this case, we need to start activity of change password. And in case of logout, we need to sign out the user. Okay, we have to sign out and start main activity. And finish this activity. Now in app start activity, in change password activity, we need to set the code to change password. Okay, we need to create material edit text for old, new and confirm password, and button to change password and Firebase user and Fire progress bar and Firebase authentication, and set toolbar for activity and we need to create in Firebase authentication instance and Firebase user and find view for old, new and confirm password. We need to add click listener to change password button. Here we need to change password. To change password, we need first to validate the three edit text for old, new and confirm password. So we need to check if the three edit text is empty or not, and check the length of the new password, and finally confirm that the confirm password is equal to the new password. If everything is right, here we need to call the change password method in activity. A change password will be done in two steps. The first step is to check the password, the old password is the right password. By authentication credential, we need to create authentication credential and it equal to email authorized provider dot get credential by Firebase user that we created in the onCreate activity method to get the email of the current Firebase user and the old password. Here, if the reauthenticate credential returns task successful, in this case we can change the password and update it. Update password requires Firebase user dot update password using text new password, and if task is successful, here we need to sign out the user and start the main activity or login activity. To login again, else we need to create toast to show the error message, and if the credential error, also there's toast to show the error message. Okay, let's try our app, but first we need to check the start activity. Okay, everything is done. Okay, let's log in. Here we can see the option menu item created. We can log out the user and log in again, and can change the password by adding the old password and creating new password. And change password. Okay, the old password is wrong. I can change it again. Let's try it. Okay, the old password is wrong. Yes, the old password is right from 1 to 8. Now we changed it to 1 to 9. Let's log in again. Successfully. Now we have full login and registration system using email and password Firebase authentication. Thank you. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel to get new videos. Thank you again.